my main questions, it's a little bit off the topic, but sort of on the same lines. What do you feel about the stand your ground? Yeah, that's a heavy one, but I mean, I'm just going to throw this in there. There has been a lot of minority kids being shot down for no reason. And when I say minority, I'm not speaking of Hispanic or even white, blacks. Black male has been shot down. The recent kid was a 15-year-old boy, last name Davis, sitting in the van, and the guy couldn't take the loud music. And, you know, open all the, eight shots?
Nine.
I mean, what? People cannot say, I mean, nowadays people are saying, well, we're all being targeted. In a sense, but you don't see young white male or not even Hispanic being shot down for absolutely no reason, and it takes the law so much time to figure it out. Why do you have to figure it out?
Well, we're on a broad band of topics here. I'm glad I'm kind of ready for the conversation. Let me say this: the question was, how do I feel about the stand your ground law? All right, I do respect the notion of, as a citizen, I shall have a right to arm myself. Okay, I respect that. I do know that America has the most prison populations than anyone in the world, and I believe we have gun control issues here in this country. Okay, so it's twofold. I respect the fact that I should be able to arm myself and protect my home. With a firearm, but I also know that it should not be that easy to get a firearm. It should not be that easy to get a automatic weapon. It should not be that easy to commit a murder in broad daylight in New York City and be able to leave the scene. That's not right. That's an issue. That's a problem. In terms of the stand your law ground and as it relates to young black males, my experience throughout my life is a bit intriguing in the sense that I can stand here and I can sit here as a principal of this large school and be in this interview and present myself in a manner that's acceptable for all who listens and hear it. I'm also comfortable enough to have a nappy beard in the wintertime. I cut it off though in the spring. And still know that I can be accepted anywhere I go. I try to tell my young males, black males in particular, that I can sit in any room. Doesn't matter who's in that room, whether it's a boardroom with executives, with shirts and ties and Caucasian males and older and all those types of individuals. But I can also go to that corner store in any inner city neighborhood if I want to go get me a Sprite. I can stand on that corner and have a conversation with anybody in any inner city, in the world. So I have the luxury of being able to be in both settings and conduct myself accordingly in both settings. Unfortunately, a lot of our young black youth and black males in particular have not been equipped with the basic skills to be able to conduct themselves in both arenas. Which is why if I'm only able to conduct myself in one arena and I'm only able to give off that persona in that arena, I am now disconnected with many other cultures, especially those who are your baby boomers, late baby boomers, older Generation X folks. Because now I'm fearful of you, not necessarily because you're a black male, that adds fear to it naturally, mm-hmm. but because if all I see through my media outlets is this type of character, if all I hear is this type of action, this type of thought, then it's only natural, unfortunately, for those who only have those experiences to now determine that's how you are when I don't know you. So my disgust, my not necessarily anger, but my sadness comes from the notion that if I talk to these two young black males, one of them definitely not graduating. Neither one of them probably are going to go to college. Both of them statistically probably going to be in prison. So when I sit here and I talk to those young men about that, my sadness goes to the fact that you don't even have the necessary hope to want to be different. I'll put it to you like this. If I sit here and I ask a young man 1 month ago, Friday, I know the date, I know the time, I know he was sitting in that seat. I was sitting in the seat there. And I asked this young man, what would it take for me to make this school better for you? I don't want to hear about nobody else or what. What would make it better for you? This young man looked at me, shook his head, and I still feel how he felt when he said it. I still see how he looked when he said it. And he looked me dead in the eye and he said, "Mr. Benton, ain't nothing you can do for us, man. These streets got us." And he said it with all sincerity. And I said, you know, that's probably the honest thing that you've ever said to anybody, man, let alone a principal. Why you tell me that? And he looked at me and simply, "Because you asked the question."